deep learning, people call it a new electricity. So it's a new types of AI that allows you to do many challenging tasks that was previously not possible. So it is a subfield of machine learning where we teach machines to do stuff for you. It's basically helping people everyday's lives. My name is Anh Nguyen, and I'm a new assistant professor here at Computer Science and Software Engineering Department. I was actually fortunate to be born in a family where my dad was a computer scientist, so I naturally got in love with computers, first by playing computer games, and then after that I started programming since my junior high. Prior to coming to Auburn, I have filed two patents. So the first one, we invented what we call a 3D touch, an input device for three-dimensional applications so that users can wear the device on their fingertips and interact with three-dimensional applications. For the second patent, I was part of the robotics group where we invented this robot that can run around, helps you monitor the inventories in your household, provide warnings, and help you with minor stuff. Auburn University actually is one of the few universities that gave me the impression that it was actually a private university. I see people are capable, and I see a huge amount of resources and capacities here that enable me to do what I want to do, basically advancing AI research. We would like to understand why deep learning works. Specifically, we want to look into these computational brains, which are like giants, artificial neural networks, understand how it works and basically how do they actually produce such a good results. And second is, from improving the understandings of neural networks, we would like to improve their robustness, which basically are critical in applications, for example, medical applications, in autonomous driving, or in security. We have a lot of data, basically a humongous amount of data than previously before. That allows us to teach computers to understand different concepts. And second is, we have also a huge amount of computing resources. Computing gets much faster and cheaper. So both of these two main reasons allows the AI to take off recently.